When you think about knots, what do you think of? Boy Scouts? Sailors? Shoelaces? What I bet you might not think about are mathematical knots. Knot theory is part of the fields of mathematical topology, which is kind of like traditional Euclidean geometry, but with the rules bent a little. In topology, this is a circle, and this is a circle, and so is this. Why is that? We care more about the characteristics of a shape rather than the shape itself, meaning we can bend and twist it many times and it'll still technically be a circle. In knot theory, however, all these shapes are also known as the unknot, the most trivial mathematical knot with zero crossings. In knot theory, knots are classified primarily by their number of crossings. There's one knot with zero, zero with one or two, one with three and four, two with five, three with six, and from that point forward, it starts to take off, and we have dozens to hundreds of knots with the same crossing number. But what technically makes a mathematical knot different from a regular knot? Why aren't these knots also mathematical knots? Well, it's simple. In a mathematical knot, the ends are joined together so that it cannot be undone. With regular knots, like maybe the knots in your shoelaces, you can just untie it and form a different knot because it isn't topologically locked. Now let's discuss some topological definitions. A knot is a closed curve in three-dimensional space. Two knots are considered the same if one can be moved smoothly through space without any cutting so that it's identical to the second. As I said, we label knots based upon their minimum crossing number, but mathematicians also classify knots by using their double points. At points in the knot's diagram, the curve will cross over or under itself. The crossing points are called double points. Each double point is assigned a positive or negative sign, depending on the orientation of the crossing point. A knot is in its ideal form if it's been moved smoothly through space so that all excess double points are removed. A simple way to represent and understand a knot is by flattening it as much as you can so that it's almost in a single plane. Then, assume you're on the road and traveling along one of the paths of the knot. Every time you come to a crossing, you can start numbering them and indicating whether you go over or under. This is one way to break down and classify a knot. Knots are important in helping us understand a range of things, from the sun's corona to quantum theory. Perhaps the two most notable are with respect to DNA and security. First, when cells divide, the DNA inside them must be replicated. This requires the DNA's double helix structure to unfurl, generate a second copy of itself that's intertwined with the first, and then get untangled. To achieve this, enzymes help to cut, unknot, and reconnect the strands. We can extend the principles of topology to DNA. The value of this method is that it gives researchers a quantitative measure for DNA packing, rather than a subjective description. Knot theory can help scientists discover the mechanisms by which these enzymes work. In the realm of security, mathematics professor William Manasco and his graduate students are partnering with the firm SecureRF to further develop the algebraic eraser, a security protocol that uses knots in cryptography. The protocol weaves mathematical information from knots and encryption keys and allows users to decipher secret data encoded in security badges, mobile payment devices, and more. For example, in the future, when quantum computers are more prevalent, quantum money will be encoded with knots instead of today's verification methods, and an algorithm will check the knots on each virtual dollar. So if you're thinking, why study knots? Instead, maybe you should be saying, why not?